In the last few movies, you learned how FBX file exported from Revit store information. Notably, you learned that a daylight system is always stored and imported into 3ds Max. This is useful when importing the Revit model into a new 3ds Max scene. However, this can be problematic when importing the model into a 3ds Max scene that already has a daylight system. You'd end up with two daylight systems. Unless you are working on a sci-fi movie and simulating a planet with two suns, this is a situation you want to avoid. The answer, of course, is to create your own import presets. This way, you can decide how to filter imported objects. Reset 3ds Max and use Import Link FBX again. Select one of the files you saved earlier. In this movie, I'll be using the provided file named RoomDay.fbx. The Manage Links dialog appears. Don't attach the file just yet. Instead, go to the Presets tab. You can create a preset from scratch or duplicate and then edit an existing one. Since we've been mostly using the Combine by Family Type preset, we'll use that as a base. Select it and then click the Copy button. Name the duplicate My Revit Combine by Type No Sun and then click OK. The new preset is added. Make sure it is selected and then click Modify. Here, you can filter the incoming data. If you want to bypass the Revit daylight system, simply disable it. You can also disable Revit cameras. Perhaps your existing scene is already set with specific shots. You can also define how materials will be managed. Personally, I like to retain any material definitions I add or modify in 3ds Max. In that respect, I usually enable these two options to prevent Revit from taking over material assignments on reload. Save the parameters to close the dialog. Go back to the Attach tab and take a look in the Preset drop-down list. Locate your newly created preset and select it. Attach the file. Notice that you were not prompted for EV settings because you didn't import any daylight system. Zoom out and notice the absence of a daylight system and of a camera for that matter. These have been filtered out and now you can rely on current lighting scenarios or on new ones you create directly inside 3ds Max. You can create as many presets as you like or need, and then choose the appropriate one that fits your project best. Speaking of projects, it is high time we get back to our original museum project. Now that you've covered many lighting scenarios, you can adapt them to bring the museum to life.